Welcome to Living 808.
Oh, hey.
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 How are you?
Happy Cinco de Mayo.
Hey. Hello, you guys. How's it?
Welcome Cinco to the de Mayo show. To you.
You know, I knew Cheech and Chong were coming in, but I didn't know they were taking over the show.
I know.
Oh, yes. Oh, you guys got
this? Usually we sit down first.
It's a friendly, not a hostile takeover.
Thank you so much.
Okay, I'm glad to hear that. We want to welcome, aloha everyone. We are so excited this morning to have two very special guests. We're going to have a fun show today. We've got the legendary comedy duo Cheech and Chong.
That's right, the iconic duo's success began stand-up comedy circuit back in the 70s, led them to 9 hit comedy albums, 8 hit movies, breaking box office records, shattering comedy album sales around the world, and actually multi-Grammy nominations. Yes. Now, they're in Hawaii for not one but 2 shows, but first, they're here with us. So again, thank you so much, guys. We're blessed to have you guys
here.
Hey. Is this an early morning for you guys?
Yeah.
Most entertainers don't wake up until much later.
Well, we're not really awake.
You know what? Neither are we. It was dark outside. Okay, I have to ask you guys, is it true that you guys actually met at a nude improv in Canada?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Well, semi-nude.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Partially. It's classy. It was,
how did that all come about?
It was optional.
Okay.
Tommy, you were there. You tell them the story.
Well, Cheech was up in Canada during the Vietnam War. He was part of a secret army in case the Viet Cong attacked from Alaska.
So I was in they were all congregating at this one strip bar in Chinatown.
Yeah, it's the headquarters.
That's your story and you're sticking to it.
It was a family-owned strip bar, you know.
Yeah.
It was, actually, it was a gift. The owner of the strip bar couldn't make a go of it, so he asked us. I had an after-hours club, and it was quite successful, so they asked us if we wanted a bar, and we said, sure. And so I got fired from Motown, and I was in town looking at the show, and the show was kind of boring, so I thought that I did some study, you know, that I found out that actresses would work for way less than strippers.
You know. Interesting. So you changed the show, right?
So what I did, I changed the show so that they were no longer strippers, they were actresses.
They got naked.
Interesting. And
they got paid less.
Within the scene, right?
Yeah.
Then we had to hire guys so you would, you know, to give the girls time to change.
That's amazing. Yeah. I got to ask, when you two guys first met, did you kind of know right then the chemistry was there?
We looked at each other, we go, what are you? It's like meeting a guy from Hawaii. What kind of strange went in?
Yeah, Cheech was the first Mexican I'd ever seen up close.
Really? Yeah. Really?
And he was the first kind of whatever he was.
Hapa
with Chinese and English.
I'm still fascinated.
Yeah.
Everyone, I look at him and touch him.
So Up in Smoke, of course, is a classic. Everybody loves that movie. Mm-hmm. Is it true that there was only, 3 pages of script? You guys created this whole movie out of 3 pages of script?
We wrote as we went along, you know. Actually, I was doing the longhand stuff. But what we did, our live show, we would do our live show, and then we'd kind of write down the important parts, you know, to remember.
The stuff you remember.
Little notes. Yeah. And that's how we did our movie.
This is crazy to you guys how successful it's been.
Amazing,
isn't it?
Over that it endures for that length of time, and every generation gets introduced to it. Every 14-year-old discovers the movies, you know, so it keeps on going.
Well, you know what? You guys are spending the whole morning with us. We're so grateful. So we're going to chat a lot more with you throughout the morning, but we're thrilled that you're here.
Are we going to is there a cooking segment?
Actually, we have some food coming up a little bit, and there's cookies all over the place, so don't worry about it. We'll get you that a little bit
rookie
later.
Pork butt.
Yeah, me too.